My name is Chris Egbalzadua. I'm a professional boxer, 5-0, signed with Matchroom Boxing and fighting real soon.
Amazing. You're here at the Matchroom Gym now. You spend a lot of time being around the gym with Virgil Ortiz. He's fighting August 10th. He's 21-0, 21 knockouts. One of the hardest workers that I know. But what was it like for you to be around him?
Oh, it's amazing. Even just sharing the ring with him just teaches you a lot. He spreads a lot of wisdom. He's just a great boxer. And I love Virgil. Him and his whole team, his dad, they're just great people.
Absolutely. And Coach Beltran and Robert and all that. Now, when you were in the gym, you did a lot of 50 sparring rounds with Sergey Voracek, the guy he's fighting. What do you remember from that?
I can't say much about it, but it was great sparring, both of them. Overall, it's just great sparring, and I'm just looking forward to seeing a great fight.
What's your prediction?
Oh, I got Virgil.
Decision or knockout?
I say knockout.
What round?
That fight is gonna last long. I say 5-7.
Okay, Tank versus Loma. Who you got?
Oh, I'm a big Loma fan. I'm always gonna go for Loma. So hopefully.
Would you put money on it?
I put money on it.
Anybody taking his money?
How much?
Andrew Ruiz wants all.
I'll put 100 on it.
What do you think?
I bet 300.
Tank or Loma? They're betting $300.
You bet?
I got Gervonta.
I got with Tank.
I got Tank.
You have to bet on it.
300.
Is this coming up or is this? Loma.
Now, 300. Hey, guys, 300. I got Loma.
I said 100.
Loma, I got Gervonta.
100.
Okay, 100.
Right now.
Like right now?
They're talking about the fight happening in November.
Yeah. I got Loma, though.
Okay, hey, that's good. You're loyal.
I respect Loma.
I never bet on fights.
I think Loma is a 126 pounder. He should be a 126 pounder. He's too.
He's a champion at 35. How can you say that?
No,
he beat
Kambosis
in Australia.
Yeah, no, he's a great one. He's a great 135, but he's too small for 135.
He's also 35. He looks way.
Yeah.
He's 35. Your body changes.
Low. What I mean, Crawford and Usyk are older than Low.
Yeah, but guess what? Usyk don't cut no weight. He's heavyweight. And Crawford, did he go up a weight?
He's about to.
There you go.
But Loma doesn't cut weight. You just said he's a 26 pounder.
Yeah, to me he should be like a 20. He doesn't cut that much.
So you're saying there's already excuses before the fight?
Nah, I still have 100% Loma isn't going to win the fight.
Loma.
Loma's a legend, an icon. He's a Hall of Famer, one of the best ever, maybe best amateur ever.
Yeah, for sure. No,
okay.
Was it like 396-1?
What would be your dream fight?
My dream fight
right now.
So I'm moving up to 140, but this is it's crazy because now there's gonna be different prospects at the same time as I go up. But right now, out of the four champions at 140, who is it? There's Matias lost the belt to Paro. Ryan didn't win his belt against Demahaney, so it's still Demahaney.
No, he vacated.
And then Pueyo got a belt. And who else got a belt at 140?
Tio.
Teofimo.
And you forgot Pitbull Cruz and Ryu.
Oh, yeah, Pitbull Cruz and
who
Ryu.
Who wins that one?
Sorry, I got Ryu.
Ryu, why?
I've always studied Ryu as I was little. He's a friend of mine, too, so I got to go. But it's going to be a badass fight. I'm looking forward to that fight.
Okay, back to the question. Which one of those four champions would you love to fight? Pitbull?
Well, I take him one by one.
Okay.
So first I go with Pueyo, obviously. And then I take Paro. Paro has one of those belts. And then I'll take Demahaney. And then I'll go for the
No, Haney's not a champ.
Not anymore. Didn't he have the WBC belt?
He vacated.
Oh, he vacated it. Yeah. So who has the WBC belt?
The guy that you mentioned.
Pueyo?
Yeah.
Okay, so Pueyo. Then who did I say? Paro. And then it's...
Tio. You forgot Tio.
Tio
and Pitbull.
Tio and Pitbull.
Okay.
Yeah, but I thought Tio would want to go up to 140.
Yeah, he's going to fight Crawford and beat Crawford.
No way. He looks more than 140.
Not even in your dreams.
Crawford's the best boxer right now.
What's her name?
Stephanie.
Crawford, Tio, who wins?
Ooh, who wins? Crawford,
Tio?
Yeah.
Crawford.
No,
Tio
wins.
That's
easy. IQ, baby, IQ. Crawford is the man. He's a smarter fighter. Right?
Yeah.
You got Tio, I got you. I got Tio.
I got
why? Tell me why.
I think Crawford stops him by like.
Why? Why you got
there's
Tio?
No way.
What's up with those shoes, by the way?
These are the fish flops.
What are they?
Only real freaking G's wear flip fish flops.
How come?
Why do you think Tio would win?
If you compare them, both of them at 140, Tio way better.
We're talking about 147.
Hold on. And Crawford only has one big win of 47 with his Spence, but Spence wasn't himself that night.
No.
Who did he beat?
Kavalyaskis.
He barely won and he got dropped. Sean Porter retired after that fight.
Sean Porter
retired.
Who was Porter? Sean Porter. Who's beating Sean Porter?
He retired after that fight. The dad said they came to lose.
He retired.
I still got it.
Well, Errol Spence, you know, after the fucking accident, he never been the same.
So you're taking the only win from Crawford's resume off?
From Showtime,
that's his biggest win.
Didn't Teofimo lose to Cambosis?
Yeah. He had life and death situation. Stop. Yeah? He had a hole in his lung.
Who you got, Majimov or Crawford?
50-50, edge to Majimov.
Majimov?
But he only has 10 fights.
I think that that style is going to get to Crawford in the beginning. It's going to throw him off a bit, but I still have Crawford winning this fight. It's going to be a great fight, though. That whole card is going to be amazing. Jerry Anderson is going to be on it.
Big Andy Baby. Reeves. Yep. Ryu and Pitbull.
That should be the main event.
So introduce yourself, Stephanie. What's your name?
I'm Captain Stephanie Simon, United States Marine Corps, Olympic Charles champion, 5-time national champion, Marine. No, I'm still in reserves.
I got a question for you.
What's up?
You're in the Marines, right?
Yeah.
Why are you wearing a Navy shirt?
Naval Academy. So I went to a college called Naval Academy where you choose between going to the Navy or Marine Corps. I chose the Marine route.
Why?
Because it's the harder, more physical, more badass, more intense, and people are fucking crazy just like boxing.
Did you see Sean Strickland?
Sean Strickland, Mr.
Did you see what he said? That Navy SEALs would not be able to hang with him in training? Did you see that?
Oh, that's a joke.
Why?
Why? Do you know what those guys go through? They will throw those guys in a 20-foot pool, hands tied behind their back, blindfolded, and say, get out. Survive. You think Sean Strickland can do that? No.
Do you think they could survive 3 days training with him?
Yes.
Why?
Because of their mentality. Those kind of guys that get through SEAL training, they're a different breed. They go through things that no human should ever go through. A whole week, no sleep. A whole week out in the water, in the sand, freezing their asses off. Holding life rafts above their head until 3 a.m. in the morning. They sleep for 20 minutes, repeat for a whole week.
What's the craziest thing you had to do in training camp?
The craziest thing I had to do in the military? One of the craziest things, I was given a map and a compass, and they gave me a bunch of boxes I had to go find in the middle of the woods. And they said, you got 4 hours, go figure it out. It was 100 degrees outside, and I couldn't use my phone, I couldn't use anything.
You did? So, you did it?
No, I failed it and fucking did not do very good.
At least you're honest. It's not easy.
Yeah, so, that's not easy.
What do you think of the failed assassination attempt? Like, that's very amateur. The way security, nothing.
Very amateur. Not even politically involved. That was very sad to see.
I didn't think there should be women in the Secret Service. At least not the ones that were around Trump. The girl couldn't put the gun in her. The girl couldn't put the gun in her holster. Then one was yelling, what do we do now? She was panicking.
Yeah.
Maybe it's not the right ones around them.
Maybe they just are not the right people. Maybe
they did on purpose. People. They gave him like the C-level ones, the ones that barely cut the class.
It could have been that. It could have been a visual thing, like who looks the best in front of Donald Trump. You want to put pretty ladies? I don't know.
She looked like Rosie O'Donnell.
Oh, never mind. Well, Rosie's pretty to somebody. Everyone's pretty to somebody, right? I don't know. I would not want to.
But I thought that was a failure in security, obviously.
Yes.
They said they saw him 4 hours before and they spotted him for 7 minutes and all that.
That's pretty sad. I mean, good on him for slipping his head, though. He had good defense.
Okay, so what's next for you career-wise?
So I'm looking to have a pro debut in September. Can't give too many details.
You were supposed to go to the Olympics.
You I won Olympic trials. I won 46. I won multiple national titles, multiple weight classes, and none of us that won the trials made the team. So we're all kind of like, what do we do now? Some people turn pro. Some people are waiting another cycle.
Who's your favorite fighter right now? Men or women?
Fighter right now? I got to go with Terrence Crawford.
Who's your favorite?
He's my favorite right now. My favorite ever is Marvelous Marvin Hagler. I can't say his name.
Crawford Madrimov, August 3rd. Who you got?
I got Crawford over everybody.
Do you know Madrimov?
I've heard of him, seen a little bit, but I got Crawford over everybody. He's my favorite fighter. What do you guys got?
I love Crawford.
See?
I love Madrimov.
Okay.
Crawford Canelo.
Ooh.
Canelo. Are we assuming that they're the same weight class?
They're fighting a 68. He's an undisputed champ. But that's how the fight works. It's called a business, and you pay him enough money.
Okay, in that case, if it's that much of a weight.
Discrepancy, 30, yeah.
If they're the same weight, I'd say Crawford any day of the week.
I feel like they're gonna. If anything, they're not gonna do that fight at 60. He'll make Crawford jump at 68 or like a 64.
But if Teofimo fights him first, it's over. Okay, what about Boots Anderson Crawford?
Oh, I don't know.
That's a tough one.
That's a good question.
That's a great fight.
They're the same. They're like the Batman Spider-Man thing. Who?
Bruce would have to move to 54. Crawford wouldn't go back down to 47 to fight.
Lippinets, a fighter. He had 500 kickboxing matches. He's a champion after 11 fights. He told me no one has hit him as hard as Boots Ennis.
Yeah.
Said the power.
I saw his fight here in LA, one of the fights.
Yes, on a Charlo card.
Yeah.
But you didn't answer.
That is a tough one, man.
The Boots, I'd pay a lot of money to go watch live Boots versus Virgil. That fight would be amazing.
Hopefully it happens. I want to see Virgil and Crawford.
You want to see Virgil and Crawford too?
Me too. I want to see that fight.
By the way,
who's team versus Crawford? Versus Virgil. Team.
Yeah.
What happened?
I don't know. Most famous person that I know that boxed in the Marines.
You know?
Yes, that famous. Harris. He passed away already. No, more famous. Respect to Jamel, but famous.
Famous?
Yes.
One of the Nortons?
No, a senator from Arizona. John McCain. I thought he used to box in the Marines. He passed away already. But
I did not know he boxed in the Marines.
I think so, yeah. Him and Bert Sugar too. Bert Sugar, the boxing historian.
What the fuck?
Oops, yeah,
sorry. They have a tournament. It's called the Sugar Burn now, though.
Because of him.
Yes.
Sugar. Yeah. He was a character.
Yeah.
He said, "Never fight in England. You're gonna get robbed." That's what he told me. I don't know.
Who's the greatest skill for skill, pound for pound fighter?
Ever?
Ever who's ever lived?
Maybe Roy Jones.
Yeah. Roy Jones Jr.
I think so. He's up there.
Who's your favorite fighter right now?
Tank.
Broner. I got
Travis Jr.
I got Bam.
I like Travis Jr. That's the homie.
Bam's my favorite fighter.
That was unbelievable.
Virgil Ortiz
for sure. I gotta. There's too much. To me right now, I think boxing is at a really, really good, really good place because there's like five good boxers at each weight class right now.
That's great.
It's really.
It's good for the sport. I just need. We want everybody to fight.
We need to fight.
We
need to fight each other. Thank to Turkey Al Sheikh for making all this happen. Saving boxing has been great.
All right, stay tuned. Tell people where to follow you.
CBAZALDUA04. That's on my Instagram, Twitter, all of that.
Get a simpler name with four letters. Yeah, like your initials and the word boxing.
CBAZALDUA04.
I understand, but.
Yeah, I know.
ES News, TMZ. Make it easy for people to find you.
I'll
abbreviate it. Sir. Even your initials and the word WBC. Yeah. Something so simple.
Yeah.
Steph Simon
Boxing. That's easy. Steph Simon Boxing. You see how simple that is?
That's easy.
Angel Reese Boxing.
Jorge Reese Official. Jackson GJ Goldman.
Don't follow him.
No, follow him.
Stay tuned. Facebook reporting.com. Reporting.